a little bit hotter for him, but a dry photographic opportunity for you anyway, so he's looking good.
He does an honest day's work for us still. Part of John's extensive collection. Now we got a Model K Bedford here. Another good old workhorse. There was a lot of these trucks around. This belongs to Lloyd and Lynn Davies. Have a look at the gear he's got on the back. He's got stationary engines and motorbikes and a bit of camping gear. Plenty of time. It's going to take you a long time to get anywhere, but you get plenty of time to look around. So we've got the Colin Keith Connors machine here, the International C1100. They bring this machine around to all the rallies, all set up for camp. So everything's nice all gone. So we've got the Peter and Glenda McCleverty owned Western Star, the Mac V61 here. Good to see these guys. Hello, Glenda and Peter. Have a seen you biking. We see this truck around at all the rallies, all the events. Thanks for bringing her up, Des. Always a very popular exhibit. Des a bit like the rest of us. He likes all things old. Now we've got a 1934 Chev. 1934 Chev truck here. He's ready to go to work. He's got the bag mower on the back there. He's got that horn working today. Give us a toot. That's a 1974 model, so that truck's been around, you know, for 50-odd years or so. It's looking great, eh? So we got the 1917 International Coal Shuttle here. This is the John Saxelby-owned truck. What a great restoration on the back there. It's very original on the front. Another one of John Saxelby's. So we got Lindsay Smith in a 1921 International. Lindsay and Sue have done a good restoration on this. They've brought her up from down Toowoomba. Good to see you, Lindsay. This is the 1971 CD 1840. Good old work as these enters. This is one of the very, very early prime movers. You can see she's only a single axle job. Then we've advanced up into the R195, which is the tandem drive job. Great restoration, sensational presentation. It's also a Saxelby truck. Down around Dolby there. Now we've got the 1930 Chef Sport. What are you doing all those kids? You had a full of kids yesterday. Have you lost them? Yeah, like we saw it. Yeah, great car there. Now we've got the 1926 Chevrolet. We're waving that furiously here. We're going to lose a hand. This is the Craig and Janelle Marshall Jeep. Have a look at her. She's got the cream cans in the back there. She's been up early, milked the cows, gone down to the factory and on the way home. Oh, I wonder who owns this year. This is the Denton Safety Needed Ute 1958 FT. Looking good. Now, yeah, this is Peter and Margaret's, what is that, EJ, is it? EJ, yeah, lovely restoration there as well. Righty-o, so we got the Ray and Margaret Gibson. This is the Model A. This is the Model A Ford Roadster, round about the 1930 era. Got the rag top there, drop that down. Be a nice convertible, that. Holy Toledo, look at this machine. That's a big car, eh? A 52 Buick with a straight 8 in it. How does she go on juice, mate? She used what? $90. It's only costing $90 to come up from Brisbane, so that's not too bad. And here we go, we've got the Rackerman family's Kenworth truck here. Candace Rackerman there, waving furiously. Well, be careful, Candace, your arm will fall off. But the Rackerman family about it.
Right on rock. Ah, you stop it. You have rock with it, and that's out of it. Ah, thanks for following.